you're fortunate enough to not have to rely on the batch generator and you have what's called a batch execution system, you can use what's called the PI event file interface. The PI event file interface will pick up and read, we will parse what are called journal files. Sometimes these are referred to as .evt files that are sent out from these batch execution systems, and then we parse those and build out all the structures and put all the data in the correct place in both tags and in the module database. It's a really slick way to put all your data into the PI system. It's nice because you don't have to capture it real time. If for some reason your event file interface should get tripped up, you can just start it up again and it will parse all the files that it missed. So it's a very easy and clean way to put your batch data into the PI system. The EVT interface will automatically configure your module database, your point database, and your batch database to accept the batch values. Now, you have a choice of selecting certain event types, and you can select which event types you want to create specific tags for and to track. We will create string tags that store your data. It stores all the data that you selected, which elements you want to record as PI properties, and we'll create a little lookup or correlation table for each batch and each thing that you're going to store. And then we'll store the data as PI batch properties, and these PI batch properties are stored much the same as the event journal lines line files are. However, keep in mind there is a 2 megabyte limit on each batch property, so you have to be a little bit careful with that. But we'll store batch information in our module database much as the EVT journal lines are constructed. I've installed the event file interface on this machine. I don't have any event files ready to go, but I wanted to just to show you some of the options that you have. I will import the event file interface file. I will import it to my server, and you can see that we have a default scan time of 30 seconds. So every 30 seconds we're going to scan a folder, and the folder is very easily set up here: event journal files directory as well as position files. You can set the directory where each of these files will be located. You can specify a specific module path, or it will create one if it encounters a module path that it doesn't see. And if you want, for some reason, to suppress either point creation or unit creation or something along those lines, you can have that set up here. Some of the general options are pretty straightforward. You can set up whether to create unit tags and things of that nature. And then here under application options is where a very very important option is set up, which server type you have, whether it's Rockwell's, Emerson, Honeywell's, Intellution, or Sequentia. Those are the type of batch execution systems that we support. You can set the event types here, which events you want to create tags for and track, as well as the event logging. You could log the string pool tags we talked about earlier. So you have a lot of different options with the event file interface, and it's a very nice way to get one of these batch systems, batch data, into your PI server.